Hello, everybody. I'm in the Littlewood, also known as Martin, and welcome back to the Escapist in Los Juárez in Pianos. Very excitable today, and I've got the orange hoodie on because it's a special occasion. The honest reason, everybody, why I haven't been wearing the orange hoodie is simply because it's usually quite cold, because I kind of just leave it over here by the window, so it ends up getting pretty freezing. And I wear an overhead hoodie, you know, my in the Littlewood one, and honestly, I'm too lazy to pull it over my head and ruin my hair. Not that this is well-kept and well-maintained, but whatever, it's fine. But anyway, I'm getting checked this morning, so I need to get all the naughty things out of my desk. And today, I think we're going to make the breakout. I believe everything is in place. We have our tunnel all the way to the northern wall. We know where Mr. Van is going to come by. We also have a spike trap for Mr. Van, which I still haven't actually researched, so I might have to make like a little research stop during exercise period like I normally do to make sure that everything is in order there. Is there anything in the loo? I don't think there is, no. And then everything else is going to be in there. I mean, I guess I could dump stuff in there, couldn't I? Other than maybe the guard outfit. I'll put the guard outfit in the wall for now, but everything else can just kind of go now. I don't really need it. Yeah, even the trowel, to be honest. There you go. I'll put the guard outfit behind the wall, and we'll be all groovy. But yeah, so today is going to be the breakout. I'm really excited about this, and it also means that we'll be finally moving on to the final normal map. And by normal, I mean it's like included in the main body of the game. And then after that, we might potentially be moving on to all of the additional DLC ones. Because this series, we're at like 30 episodes now. It literally shows no signs of slowing. And I just wanted to thank you all for that. Like, I really, really do enjoy this game. I find when I play some other games that I can't keep like a flow of conversation with myself going, because I just feel like the game either doesn't engage me enough or I'm not that hyped about it. But this game, I find it so easy to record, and I think it comes across really well. And you giving me tips as well has been such a massive thing for the channel recently, hasn't it, with all this like kind of viewer input. It's been great. So what do we want to do today? I honestly have no idea. I think strength is definitely a thing that I want to get up today. I definitely need to make sure that I've got the maximum amount of health. So if for whatever reason the snipers or the guards or whatever else suddenly turn on me, then I'm going to be okay and I'm going to be able to still get out of this prison. I also still need to find myself a bit of timber today and combine it with duct tape and the flimsy pickaxe in order to upgrade it to a sturdy one. That's very important for us to do. Just mainly because that will allow us basically to break out of the bottom wall a hell of a lot quicker. I will look up the spike trap soon. What are you selling, Simon? A flashlight. I did say I wanted one of those, didn't I? Yes, I will take that. Not that I think it does anything. Let's have a little look. It does say 100%. It says 100%, but I don't understand how you would use that. And when you hold shift over it, it doesn't say anything either. Maybe if I wear it? No. How strange. I'm going to have to look that up as well. But before all that, let me get myself back up to my 100 strength. I'm not sure my stamina is going to hold out for it. So let's just quickly run back to La Shower. Yeah, we got like two points off of it. Ooh, who's down? Glass shard, spatulas. That's not a problem. So what odd jobs have we got? Like, relocate a roll of toilet paper. That is so easy to do. And also finding the book as well is going to be really, really good. Because I get the feeling if I don't find timber on somebody, then somebody must be selling it at some point. Or I'll find it in a desk. But I honestly think like beating up people today is probably going to take up like 80% of the episode. Unless Tutron is going to be our hero. Not quite. Not quite. Never mind. All right, so you two are going to kick the crap out of each other. I will fight the victor. Winner stays on and all that. Come on. God, you two aren't half taking your time, are you? Bloody hell. Are you like slapping each other rather than actually fighting? There you go. And you're down as well. Thank you. Who has an item that I'm looking for? Neither of you. No bloody person has what I'm looking for. Let's quickly get this up to 100 then. Keep it going. And one more dumbbell. And I think that is not there. And the next one, there you go. There's my 100 strength. Right, exercise period. Let's use this time to actually research the flashlight and also the spike trap as well. All right, I've done my research. So it turns out that the torch, I think it kind of automatically activates when you go into either a tunnel beneath the ground or if you're using it at nighttime. So I think it obviously detects the lighting levels and goes, right, yeah, you probably want to use this right now. So I have to wait until then to actually use it. So I will do that, but I don't think that's going to matter too much because we have the stinger strip, which is going to stop the Jeep from coming around. Mr. Van is going to be feeling a lot of hurt and pain tonight. It's not going to be fun for him. Wow, my intellect is taking a pretty heavy hit as well. That's fine, I can do that. Is anybody selling? Toots is still selling the same old guff, and Simon is down, so I can't even do that. I've checked Simon's body. He's got nada on him. Let's wait for him to leave. There you go. Oh, book! Book! I found a book! I don't know who needed the book. Can't remember who it was, but I'm going to wait for Simon to get up so I can buy off of him. Let's see what he's selling. Please be a bit of timber. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Okay. No. You don't have on you what I was hoping you would. Not a problem. Let's grab some toilet paper out of just somebody random's desk. That's Aaron. There's Ross. Ross wanted the bog roll, didn't he? So we're going to give you that. Thank you very much, sir. And then was it Simon who needed the book? No, John needed the book. All right. Where's John at? TB, where are you? Does he have a job? Maybe he does. Although, don't think he does. No, that's Simon. I always forget what John looks like. I think John's just straight up bald. Is that him? Yeah, there he is. All right. John, here's your book, mate. There you are. Not a worry. Right, let's find ourselves another bit of timber. Oh, there's another fight going on here. We might find some timber on one of these two. There you go. Aaron, you're going down as well, my friend. Sorry about that. And chocolate bar will be helpful tonight. And sand. Really? Okay. It's not what we were looking for, but that's okay. I am just going to make sure that my intellect is at least 90 because I don't know what the intellect requirement is to actually upgrade a pickaxe. And obviously, as soon as nighttime strikes and the cell doors are locked and everything, I'm not going to have access to this room. So as long as I make sure it's a good, like, 94, 95, I don't think it will deteriorate that quickly. Let's have a little look where we're at, though. We've got 88. Okay, that's all right. That's fine. We could probably even crank it up to 100. And one thing that I did get, actually, I got a crafting note on how to make, like, an unvarnished chair, which I thought was really, really strange. I don't know if you use that almost in the same way as a stepladder, but the recipe for it was, like, three timber, I think. Just literally just that. Somebody else must be selling, right? Let me see. Ah, Trot's selling. What you got? Timber! There it is! All right. Let's see if we can go and upgrade our pickaxe to a sturdy one. Whoop, 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 whoop. There you go. Let me pick up some of this. Ah, yeah, look, the torch is activated. So how do I know when it goes down? Oh, God, yeah, look at that. I can actually now see all of the mines. We had a pretty lucky straight here, didn't we? Look at that. Wow, I'm seeing this in a whole new light. All right, okay. So now it goes small, and when I pick it up, it goes full again. I don't understand how it deteriorates, though. It seems to last forever. Like, it seems really, really good. So I am just going to drop that there, because I don't need it at the moment. Let's grab the flimsy pickaxe, and let's throw these three together. Lightweight pickaxe. So I guess if I find one more timber, I can make a sturdy one, but that's not too much of an issue right now. So we've got the trowel, which we can swap for a 100%. I'm going to get rid of these trowels and put that there. The torch is going to live here as well. And I'm going to move all this stuff away just so it doesn't confuse me when it comes to nighttime. All right, shower block time. Do we have all the pieces in place? I believe we do. I think we've got a 4 out of 5 weapon. We've got really high health. Our intellect is high enough in case we need to craft anything in a hurry. Chocolate is something that we need to kind of fill this area up with. So I'm going to drop a bar of that just there. Let me just jump out of here. Two, we got the guard outfit just there, which I could probably do with bringing with me. It's a little bit in a shady spot. Number three. Oh, God. Quick, 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 quick. There you go. And then into... There you go. All right. So it's going to be evening roll call immediately after this. Oh, no! Don't happen right now. Don't happen right now. God, thank God. I thought we were in serious trouble there. I thought we were going to be really, really big trouble. I had a watch in my desk the whole time that Sparkles could have had. Never mind. All right. Let's just go to evening roll call. Let's just quickly grab these so I can make a dummy because that's something we are going to need. Boom, boom, boom. Chocolate on the floor. There you go. All right. Let's just quickly do this. There you go. Number four. Actually, I'll hold that for a second. There you go. I'm going to drop the watch and then bring that with me. Good. All right. Who's getting checked? Did I see it in time? And to Malfoy. Great. So they are going to come into my room, which isn't fun, but it doesn't really matter all that much. All right. Here's the escape attempt, everybody. Escape attempt number one. I have a backup of this save, so if all goes tits up, I can basically have another go at this. But I don't think that's going to be the case. I think we're going to be all right. All right. Here we go, then. So Ant is asleep. The doors are locked. And fingers crossed, the guards are going to come and have a little nosy at Ant's desk. And then we'll worry about the rest later on. Come on. I mean, I kind of waited on them to do that last time, and they just never turned up, did they? Somebody told me if I do that and then press not yet, then that means that it's happened. That might be a lie. But anyway, I think I'm just going to go for it. Why not? Do we have any more chocolate we can bring? Yes, we do. I'm going to drop the bed sheet in there. I'm going to leave a slot open. Just for that. There you go. Good. And now we're going to switch out into our outfit. There you go. And then we're going to drop the poster there. Drop the poster there. And there. We've got the stinger strip, which is what we need. Guard outfit or prison outfit can stay there. And then I guess from now, We're going to wait up here. I know we've just heard Mr. Fan, but I wasn't quite prepared for that. So let's do all of this. Leave some chocolate there. So we're going to need one slot open for the dirt, which I guess can be number 6 or maybe number 1. Yeah, maybe if I do that as number 1. So if I do this and then pick up the remaining of our items, there we go. I'll obviously pick up the torch last. So it just basically means then when I actually dig, that the hole is going to be in number 1. There you go. So that looks like our setup, doesn't it? We've got the stinger strip for Mr. Fan. We've got the trowel. We've got a pickaxe. I guess we can bring the torch as well. Maybe. I don't think I need it. If the van isn't going to be coming around, I don't think I need it. I'm going to try without. Okay, there's Mr. Van. Okay, that means he's gone. I think that means he's been and gone. Let's give this a go. Come on, trowel. Don't fail me now. 24%. This takes way longer to dig than I was anticipating, actually. Ay, caramba. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There you go, 60%. We're almost about to surface. Oh, God. This makes me so nervous, this game. Like, I hate it so much. So much. All right, and up we go. We're going to cover that over. We're going to drop the stinger strip just there. And then, fingers crossed, that will mean that Mr. Fan now gets stuck. I do have a bar of chocolate on me. If I can try and use it on myself and not on the floor. There you go. Fatigue is right the way down. And now we're ready to press number 4 and break through this bottom wall. Just hug the wall. If you stand anywhere around here, you're bound to get blown to Timbuktu. Oh, what was that sound? Okay, that was the van. Mr. Van's popped a wheel. Yes. Okay. So we know he's directly at the top of the screen right now. So it means that we've probably got enough time to do this thing. Come on, come on, come on. 84%. Oh, God. 68%. Oh, come on. I hate this so much. My fatigue is totally fine right now. Come on. 20%. Oh, my God. Yes, 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 yes. 4%. 4%. Oh, my God. Get through. No, wait, wait. It's the opposite direction. God, Mr. Van almost caught us. Can you believe that? That was so close. Oh, my God. The wall didn't break through when I expected it to. There you go. The wall's down. And we're out of there. We did it. Oh, yes. We're out of San Pancho, everybody. I'm so happy about that. Well, there we go. That is San Pancho or Las Guaguas Infiernos completed. So in the next episode, we are heading into the final basic map, should I say. It's called Iron Gate, but of course we like to pick our own names. So if you have any suggestions for those, leave them in the comment section below and I'll pick either one from that episode or the next one once people have actually experienced the prison for the first time. And yeah, I'll see you all in a little bit. Bye-bye.